Hi everyone, my name is Erica and I'm going to show you 10 different barbell squat variations to add to your routine. The first variation is a low bar squat. So I'm just getting under the bar, I'm putting it right below my traps and above my rear delts, creating kind of a shelf on my back by squeezing my upper back together. And this type of squat is commonly used by power lifters because usually this bar positioning will let people lift a little bit more as opposed to the high bar squat, which will be the next variation. So I'm just going down to about parallel and coming back up and putting it safely on the bar. The next squat variation is a high bar squat. So for this one, it looks a lot similar to the low bar squat that I just talked about, but the bar sits instead on your traps. So as you can see, the bar is a bit higher on my back and my posture is a bit more upright for this one as opposed to low bar squats. And this usually lets people get a bit more range of motion. So bodybuilders like to use this squat variation generally more often than the low bar squat, but it's up to personal preference. The next variation is called a box squat. For this one, you can really use either a high bar or low bar positioning on your back, whichever is more comfortable. And you'll just want to find some sort of stool or a bench or something that you could sit on at the bottom of the movement. But what I like to do for this is to just tap the stool instead of fully sitting down on it and kind of like losing your tension or using too much momentum to get back up. And this is really helpful if you want to work on your squat sticking point or work on power getting out of that bottom position of the squat. This next variation is called a B stand squat, and I am taking a staggered stance with one foot fully on the ground and the other one only has my toes on the ground. And this is a good variation to work on single leg strength. That's a little bit easier than some variations that are only using one leg, since you still have the support from the back leg as well. And this might feel a little bit awkward, but just try around with different foot placements to see what's the most comfortable for you. This next one is a full range of motion squat. And something to keep in mind is that everyone has a different range of motion based on your anatomy and your flexibility and stuff like that. So I can get super low into this squat. That's comfortable for me, but it's not comfortable for everyone. So if you can't go this low, just go as low as you can, and you can work on some flexibility or changing your stance if you want to go lower into your squat. But a full range of motion squat is really good for bodybuilding and getting the most leg musculature that you can. This next squat variation is called a Zercher squat. And for this variation, as you see, I picked up the barbell in the crooks of my elbows and then just kind of squat like normal. And some people do this because front squats hurt their wrists when they hold the bar, so they elect to put the bar in their elbows instead, and it helps them. For some people, it might help you get into a deeper squat or transfer over into things like a strongman. The next variation is called a zombie squat. And similar to the Zercher squat, this variation is for people who might not feel too comfortable doing front squats because it hurts their wrists. So for this variation, you just hold your arms straight out in front of you and squat. And this also is nice because it reinforces an upright posture when you squat. So it might be helpful for people who tend to have a little bit too much forward lean during their squats usually. But this is a great variation to replace a front squat or in addition if you like how it feels. This next variation is just a normal front squat. So as you can see, I have my elbows out in front of me and I'm gripping the bar with just my fingers and resting it on the front of my shoulders. As I mentioned, some people might feel like this is a little hard on their wrists, but it's really great for developing your quads and putting more of the emphasis there instead of on your posterior chain. So it's really good to give this or some other variation with the bar in front of you a try in your routine. This variation is a heel elevated squat. So you can take a plate or something small like this piece of wood under your heels and then just do a regular squat over it as far down as you can go. This is a really great variation to target your quads. You can even
do a higher elevation by stacking up multiple plates to stand on, which is what I like to do usually, and that just places an even greater stimulus on your quads.
The next variation is pause squats. And for this one, you set up just like a normal squat. You take the bar off of the rack, and then as you go down into the bottom position, you will hold it for just a second or two to start out with, and then later on you can start adding longer and longer pauses. But this really helps to enforce proper form if you're struggling with leaning forward too much or having your knees cave in or something like that on the way up. This can really help you to drill down your technique. And that was the last squat variation. Make sure to give some of these a try in your next routine.